Thanks to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. How would the universe change if you approached the speed of light? What would everything around you look like? How would space and time act? The answer is a lot different from what you are currently used to. To travel the speed of light isn't actually possible for anything other than massless particles, like photons. It would require infinite energy to get something with mass to that speed. The energy required exponentially goes up the closer you get. But there are instances of matter coming close. We've observed some particles traveling 99% of the speed of light. Now, for you and me, we have no hope of ever approaching these speeds. But if you did manage it, what happens to space and time from your perspective would be very noticeable. Let's ease you into this, as it's going to be a bit tricky to wrap your head around. We will simulate going from standing to traveling almost the speed of light. This is a fun little game called A Slower Speed of Light, released by MIT, demonstrating what would happen if the speed of light got progressively slower, eventually to walking speed. At first, my character looks around and sees the world normally. But as I start to pick up these orbs, instead of speeding me up, the game slows the speed of light down to simulate what it would look like if we were traveling extremely fast over vast distances. As the speed of light slows, what becomes apparent to you? The first thing I notice is that the colors start to change. This is because of something called the relativistic Doppler effect. You see, when you look around and you see color on objects, this is because light is reaching your eyes at specific wavelengths. The longest wavelengths you can see are reds. The shortest wavelengths are violets. Beyond the range of our sight are the infrared and ultraviolet. But when you are going very fast, because of the Doppler effect, some of the wavelengths that were in the infrared and ultraviolet now shift to wavelengths you can detect. Suddenly, things that were invisible to us before become visible, like heat in infrared and fluorescent substances in ultraviolet. The faster you travel, the larger your visible range now becomes. Light does travel in waves, but it is also a stream of particles called photons. As you head into the flow of particles at speed, the more particles will hit your eye, making everything ahead of you brighter. On the other hand, if you look behind you as you travel forwards, everything will get darker because less photons are reaching you. This is known as the searchlight effect. What else do you start to notice? You may notice that we seem to be gradually speeding up. But actually, our speed always stays the same throughout the game. We are just walking like we were at the beginning. This is the result of special relativity, namely time dilation. One of the laws of the universe is that the speed of light is a constant. However, space and time are not, and can be warped. So when you are moving, two things change: your time and your distances relative to stationary observers. Let me explain. Time goes slower for an object that goes faster. This has been proven. If you have two clocks, one stationary and the other in rapid motion, say on a rocket, the times on each will go out of sync. This is why the times on satellites in orbit around Earth need to be occasionally adjusted, or they'd go out of sync with Earth-based clocks. Not by much, a few milliseconds per year, but they would add up eventually. The faster you go, the more time dilation happens, until, should you hit the speed of light, the rate of time reaches zero. This means photons, or light particles traveling the speed of light, are unaffected by the passage of time. But let's go back to how time dilation affects us in the game. Removing the lighting effects will help us see this a lot more clearly. Now remember, throughout the game, our walking speed stays the same. It's the speed of light that slows down as we collect more orbs. And yet, it seems that we move a lot faster towards the end of the game than at the beginning. What is happening here is that our time is going slower than everything around us. As a result, it's like the distances of space are shorter, meaning we get somewhere quicker from our perspective. In practice, this means that if we traveled in a vehicle that approaches the speed of light, we travel for 1 year at that speed, it all seems normal for us, but 10 years have passed for people on Earth. Should you actually be able to travel the speed of light, you could get anywhere in the universe instantaneously from your perspective, but on Earth, however far in light years your journey takes you, will equal the equivalent amount of years from their perspective. So, do you want to go 40 light years away and can travel the speed of light? You get there instantaneously from your perspective, but for people on Earth, you show up there 40 years later. Again though, in practice, light speed travel is impossible for anything made of matter. The last effect is a weird one. It's like our field of view changes. This is from the effects of the aberration of light and the Lorentz transformation. Light takes time to reach our eyes, and when we see anything, we are seeing that object in the past. Even now, you are watching this video with a tiny, tiny, tiny time delay, as light takes time to leave your screen and reach your eyes. As we move in the game, that object we are seeing isn't where we think it is anymore. You may have thought, as you've been watching this video, that I must be useless at computer games because I keep crashing into walls and missing orbs. But this effect means that I'm not standing where I think I am, because the more orbs I have, the slower light is traveling. So I actually need to start turning a little ahead of what I'm used to, which is difficult to comprehend while navigating. It's like playing with lag. This effect also means that I can see much more of my surroundings in one go. This animation helps show why. The light source is moving relative to me as I move forward. But because the beam of light takes time to reach me, I see where it was relative to me in the past. When there is a lot to see around me, it's as if my field of view increases the faster I travel, as I'm suddenly seeing all these objects as they were relative to me in the past. Light, space, and time get more complicated still, but I won't delve into it in this episode. All I can say is that I'm glad light appears almost instantaneous for us. This game was a bit of a thought experiment to see what the world would be like if light was slow. But it hasn't even gone into the other really problematic scenarios, like Earth traveling around the sun at the speed it does, how all our electronics would be affected, and other major issues. In the opposite vein, us being able to approach the speed of light would be beneficial for traveling large distances in short times. However, time is passing normally for people on Earth, meaning traveling anywhere in the universe and coming back again could be possible for you. But Earth would look a lot different on your return, with years, decades, millennia, or more having passed, depending on how far you went. On your journey, due to the various effects, outside your ship everything would look warped, your field of view would be greater, a greater range of light wavelengths become visible, and in front of you would be much, much brighter. So, there we have it, how your universe would change if you approach the speed of light. Thanks again to Squarespace for sponsoring this video. Squarespace gives people a powerful and beautiful online platform from which to create your own website. They have a bunch of features which you can integrate seamlessly into your own website, like their audio block feature to embed your podcast or music with iTunes support, or something I find particularly useful, which is the ability to link various social media platforms to your website and embed videos. So, if you're looking to build a website, give it a go. If you use the link squarespace.com/Astrum, you can try it out for free and get 10% off your first purchase. Thanks for watching! Did you like this video? Check out the playlist for more Astrum Answers. Do you want to help pick the next question that gets answered? Become a patron or a member and take part in the fortnightly polls. Links are all in the description. All the best and see you next time.